DNA. It's great for helping you learn about your ethnicity and maybe find some cousin connections. But it also has the habit of blowing the lid off of family secrets. Howdy, I'm Devin Noelle with Family History Fanatics, and this is a segment of DNA with a twist. Today, we're going to talk with Victoria Wu, a will and probate attorney here in Texas. But before we talk to any lawyer, they always have to give a disclaimer. And remember, this is YouTube. You shouldn't be getting all of your legal advice from YouTube.
As a disclaimer, nothing herein can be taken as legal advice. You must contact a licensed attorney in your jurisdiction for your specific needs, and nothing herein constitutes the formation of an attorney-client relationship.
Today's DNA question of the day has two sides, both a legal component and an emotional component. How do you handle non-paternal events, the unexpected surprises in DNA?
Well, keep in mind if you submit your DNA because you're looking for somebody, keep in mind that there's third parties involved that may not be aware that there are issues out there, so you may want to stick to an adoption registry. Just from an emotional standpoint, there's not really a legal standpoint, but just from an emotional standpoint. When you click okay and you submit your stuff, you have written off any liability from those DNA companies. If there's any surprise or you find out your dad's not your dad or your grandpa's not your grandpa or what your parents aren't your parents or whatever, they have no liability to you whatsoever for those results, and you click okay on your terms of use when you do that. So just keep that in mind. If you're doing some family testing and you find out that someone in your family isn't maybe quite in your family, you don't really have a legal obligation to tell them. So you have to strongly consider, you know, what you feel is right, depending on their age, maybe family circumstances. I think some people kind of suspect sometimes, but that's something you have to consider, but you don't have a legal obligation necessarily to tell them.
Okay.
Now, if they ask you, you know, you may have to come clean, but.
So how direct do they have to be? No, I mean, like, seriously, I know that's a question. Like, how direct they have to be before you have to reveal? What do you think?
Well, I mean, I think if they say, hey, did, you know, anything, if they say, hey, what, you know, how did it show up? What am I? And you go, well, you know, you're 53% German and you're 10% British, and, you know, move on with your life. But they say, hey, you know, did I link up with family? What have I linked up with? Okay. Everything. And I think then, you know, it gets a little harder. And again, it comes down to the specific situation, family dynamics, and that if it's an older person, you know, maybe you don't tell them, you know, it's really going to be unique to that situation, but you don't necessarily have a legal obligation to tell them.
Connect with us on Twitter and Facebook. Twitter @FHFanatics or Facebook Family History Fanatics.